Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Destiny and Death from Above. It's Monday. We're going to talk about the hard light. I was thinking about guns that I wanted to look at, things I wanted to talk about. And then I was just looking at my inventory, and I was looking at the hard light, and I was thinking, I've never really used you. Are you a worthy exotic? So it made me beg that question. So I thought I'd get in here and shoot it on stream. Talk about it. We're going to go over the advantages and disadvantages, the exoticness of it. Do some fun stuff. Shoot some mans with it. Probably do some PvP and go into it that way. So that sounds like fun. Let's do it. Let me get my gear back like I like it. So we can do that. But good morning. Welcome. I am Death from Above. This is a stream video thing that I do every day, 6 to 7 a.m. It's about 6:15 right now. It took me a little bit to get online because I didn't decide what video I wanted to do until just now. And made the thumbnail, got online, got things hooked up, and now we're doing it. So we're going to grab a couple Crucible Bounties, go do some PvP, talk about the hard light, see what we think about it. I'm going to be very PvP focused today just because I think that's something that's more up the hard light's alley. In PvE, I don't know. It's interesting, but I think in PvP it's a much more fun conversation just because of the exotic talent it's got. So here's the hard light, and we'll take a look at it. It is an Amalan exotic. This is one of those year one exotics that's made into year two that I'm still enjoying, I think. We'll see. But I have a 400 level hard light. It's got some different options. We can definitely go max stability with this sucker. Right now I've got it set on max impact and some stability. I don't believe quick draw is that necessary on a primary weapon, but whatever. We got fitted stock, glass half full, spray and play, quick draw, volatile light, accurized ballistics, CQB, ballistics, and aggressive ballistic. Aggressive will give you that max impact, CQB will give you that max stability, and accurized will give you that max range for the gun, not, you know, of anything. But volatile light is the exotic talent. Rounds fired from this weapon have no damage fall off, over-penetrate targets, and ricochet off hard surfaces. So that's a really interesting combination. Something that's going to be a lot of fun in close quarters PvP combat. So I think we're ready to go. We're going to do some clash. I didn't check to see what the daily was. If it's control, we might do control. One of the two, clash or control, just to work on a bounty and talk about this into some PvP. But let's see what it is. It's Supremacy. I think Supremacy would be an excellent game mode for this. So let's drop some other things, pick up those two Supremacy bounties. We'll see if we can't get a Crucible package out of all of this. Cycle of Light. We're going to drop that one. Pick up two more. So what do you guys think about the Hard Light? Do you still use it? I know Carcouche says he prefers the Monte Carlo, thinks it's a bit better. I do agree with you on that. It probably is a bit better. But we'll see. Solar weapons, precision kills, cabal, blah, blah. You can do some of these in PvP. We'll grab that one. Not too worried about my legendary mark situation because I've got so dang many. The situation is more of a glimmer weapon parts situation as far as my materials go. But guys, if my internet seems a little shaky, it is. I don't understand what's going on. I've got the preview up. Everything looks good. So give me some feedback if you see things going on with the stream. But we're gonna get into the daily. We'll do Supremacy as the first match because usually these engagements are much closer quarters and kind of probably where the hard light's gonna shine the most. Dudo7, what's up? I'm calling you Dudo7. If you want it pronounced any other way, you're just gonna have to let me know. But so we're gonna talk about the hard light. And so let's look at it and kind of get a little bit more analysis going. So the hard light, year one auto rifle, ionized polymer, syn ballistic attack platform. The system's lethality is dynamically robust across tactical spaces. Yup, sounds like something my brother would write. Just fine. So it's an exotic. It's kind of a mid impact tier. Auto rifle, mag size of 40. It does have really good stability and reload. Even without fitted stock, it's got good stability and reload. So it's a very quick gun. I don't know. I'm interested to see how it performs. I've never taken the time to just get into a game mode with it and go to town. So right now it's a gun that I don't have a lot of experience with. I've had it since before, you know, year three. I've had it since year one, since you could get it. And I've just never quite used it. I think at the very beginning, it was really just awful. All it did was bounce rounds around, and it didn't do anything else. They added the overpin trait and the no damage fall off later, kind of in the history of the gun. And now, it's decent. You remember Hardlight was the meta in the period in the middle of 2.0? Really? Yeah, I guess before auto rifles were nerfed into the ground. It still should be decent. It still should be competitive because of mid-tier auto rifles are not that bad. I almost run around some trials with it just to piss people off. So the options for today's stream, there was a couple different ones. There was the Hardlight. There was doing off-meta PvP stream where I grab just totally opposite of the meta weapons and do like some trials or something. There was a just do some trials. That was my other option. Or there was a do some survival in the division. The first time when Thorn and Last Word were nerfed. Okay. So those are my options on what to do today. Mondays, Sundays, Mondays, and Thursdays, I don't really have a plan. As far as videos go, every other day of the week, I kind of have a good staple video, stream, whatever this is that you want to call it. Live stream video thing. You may not ever get a match. Match times have been increased. My guy is very ready, though. He's very ready. Like, extremely ready. Let's work on our shader. How does that look? He's very ready. I don't like it. I do like the Iron Banner shader. I don't know why I like this shader. It's kind of weird. We can get rid of the tire, probably. Yeah, I'm not ever going to use that again. Sorry, future Warcold. I'm just not. Midas? We could be a gold man. You're a gold man. I got this one to drop. Rose Bright. Did we look at Dawn's? Yeah, and my old favorite. I used to run this shader exclusively. God of War. Just red. It's just red. Let's just do red. That's what we're going to do today. I don't know if people aren't playing Destiny, if it just only want to match me with people close by, but I'd really like to play the game. Started playing Battlefield 1 yesterday. It's interesting. I think the way I'm playing it's kind of a slow, boring way. I was trying to do scout rifle stuff, and I'm not very good at it, so I need to do other things. I need to just do, like, assault stuff. There we go. Got your match going. So let's see how the hard light performs. We're going to run Striker Titan, Armamentarium, like I always do in PvP. I'm really excited. Like, I like the way there's so many different options for armor and the way it looks. They can all be max light. I'm kind of glad they're not all like the raid gear where you have to have certain things. I wish there was more interesting perks. Like this raid armor has the melee bonus agility per melee kill stacks for 20 seconds. I use that a lot anytime I'm doing PvP, but I hate the look of those boots. I hate them. I think they're awful. But like this chest piece, it's a really cool looking chest piece. I do enjoy it, but doesn't really have anything special on it. So we're going to test the meta. We're going to stress the meta. We're going to get up in the meta's face and say, hey, look at this gun. Isn't it fun? We're going to do it. Do it for about 20-30 minutes. Just until it's tired of us and then it tells us to go home. Go home, you're drunk. I'm coming for you, meta. Bow. I can't even get to my menus right now. I can't even get there. All we're doing is loading in. That's it. That's all we're doing. I feel like I'm playing more games now than I've ever played before at one time. I've got Destiny, which I always play. We got The Division, which is a lot of fun, but I'm really only playing survival at this point. The Witcher, which I picked up, Witcher 3, but I haven't really played too much. And Battlefield 1, and I have Titanfall that I need to finish. All these games. If you're interested in any of those games, let me know in the comments or let me know in the chat. Because I'll play them. I need to finish Titanfall. That might be something I do on Thursday. Get into Titanfall and just run around and shoot things. Titanfall's a fun game to watch. Because the movement is just so interesting. Alright, we got the hard light. We got it on max impact right now. I'm thinking I might need to put it on max range. Where are we going? Where are we going? Ooh, don't go in there. Can I hit somebody with these? I'm just trying to bounce light. Because you can bounce it and it hits just as hard as the original projectile. Oh, yes, yeah, supremacy. Ooh, oh. Axion Bolt killed me? I can't believe in that. Get my crest. Thank you, bro. Thank you, bro, for redeeming my crest. Alright, hard light. Ooh. So far, it's not... 21 of the head's okay. Matador 64 is going to kill you every time, though. Every time. It's a little... It feels hard to control. Honestly. It feels very hard to control. You're dead. Down. 22 to the head. Oh, glass half full was procking. It's very hard to control, actually. That thing feels like it's bouncing around like a crazy person. Interesting. I think that was the main problem with it. It had such awful stability. Such awful stability. Yeah, that stability is way bad. Let's see what we can do about that. I'm going to go for max stability with CQB ballistics. We don't need spray and play. I think I'm still good with that talent setup. But we're going to go max stability and see what that does. Because, honestly, it shouldn't have damage falloff, so you should be able to hit anything from any distance. Right? I know there's other things in play, but... I did not like that stability situation. I remember now. He remembers. That's... Good grief. This guy with the Matador. I do like playing shotgun on my hunter because you are very mobile. Like, not in like a pure speed kind of way, but just in a... Shoot you. There we go. Ace of spades. Alright. Continuing on. It's doing okay. It's something that might take some getting used to. Back up. It does throw people off pretty bad. You're just rocking and rolling on them with the bouncing projectiles. It will throw some people off. Too many mans. Bugged out of there quickly. Push forward. Be a dummy. That's the type of situation you're going to have to play for. Just a dumb move on the opponent's part. Oh, please don't have quiver. Quiver, he had quiver. Why am I lagging? I can't get through a match without being red bar or yellow bar at some point. It just happens now. Okay, we got him. There is damage falloff, though. I shouldn't have any damage follow, but I definitely am getting lower damage numbers. Maybe it's the glass half full that I keep seeing. Ooh, you got wrecked. What? I didn't have no health. At villing when you don't have the right weapon out ever. For the range stuff, I had the shotgun. For the close range, I had the auto rifle. Just never worked out. Alright, we're going to get a double kill with this. There we go. That works. That guy died very slowly. Come here. Alright. So, preliminary data suggests it's very unstable, but it's still an enjoyable gun to use. It's just the consistency of the headshots is not there. Come through that doorway. Locking it down. Nope, I don't got it.
5 minutes remaining. Heavy ammo available.
I guess you should. Yeah, I'm still doing max damage. What is this guy doing? Dead. Yeah, so you don't have any damage fall off. It's interesting, though. Very interesting. Alright, I'll be right back. That's the alarm to wake up my wife. I'll be right back. She hit my snooze button until 7 a.m. So I won't be back until 7. Hello? Is it me you're looking for? No? Oh, what is this guy doing? I swear he's doing some weird things. Get off me. Contacting Destiny servers. Yay. Stop it. Stop it. I'm back. I'm not dead. Okay, yeah. All right. So we're in here. Watch. Okay. We need a hard surface. Such a close match. So I don't have to win. Like, there's no reason for me to win. All right. Look at this wall right here. This is not ADSing, not holding any of the sticks. That's ridiculous. All right. ADSing, not holding the sticks. With full stability. That's max stability. That's okay. That is okay. It's not the greatest. Ooh, very dead. Clever dragon. I had no chance. It's just, I don't want it to bounce so much left and right. If it had a little bit of a better option for stability left and right, it would be amazing. The exotic talent, I think it is exotic worthy. Like, that is a worthy talent. They didn't see it coming. That's what she said. Guys, get out of the way. Where'd this guy go? Where'd this guy go? Any of you guys that have been watching my videos for a long time feel like it's about to end right now? I haven't used this as my outro song in a while, though. I don't want to fight all of you. I want to fight one of you. I mean, you know, happens. Can I hit him with the ricochets, please? Where are you? Who's gonna win the Matador fight? He was not even aimed at me. I think it gave me the kill. All right. So I need your opinions on the hard light. What do you think about it? Is it worthy? Is it fun? Do you ever use it? Do you even still have it in your inventory? That's the question. Question of the day. So many mans. I haven't used it in a long time. We won. Huh. There we go. Did it. I guess we can end the video on this song. No, I'm just kidding. We're going to keep going. It's only 6:30. We'll keep going. Short answer is no, Monte Carlo. I do agree that Monte Carlo does feel... It has better options as far as talent setup, gear perk setup. You can't really get this one under control. Like, here's what we're going to do. We're going to go max aggression. And so we're going to go max impact, max whatever. We're just going to have no stability. Although, I don't think there's any reason to use quick draw over fitted stock. Because I'm not in a situation where I'm really drawing this. Forget about high. What's up? Forget about hard light. I would. So So max impact and range. Aggressive is max impact. Let's go max. I don't know that you really need max range. If they have no damage fall off, what's the point of max range other than making the hitboxes, I guess, bigger? Maybe? I don't know. But, you know. Get them boots out of here. So what are we doing as far as bounties go? I'm going to try to finish some of these. Oh, look at that. Hello. And hello, we are not getting that crucible rank right now. Hey. Crest denied. All right, let's go do some clash. Feel like some clash? Cancel. Cancel. If you press the button harder, it is more likely to cancel, right? There we go. Let's press it for a good solid 10 seconds before it actually hit anything. All right, we had trouble finding a match for Supremacy, so I think finding a match for Clash is going to be even harder. I really want to get into some... I mean, that was pretty close quarters some of the time, and the projectiles, when they ricochet, they just don't hit. They just don't hit. So, I don't know. Like, I was noticing I would shoot it at people in the rooms, and it just... It's not hitting them. I don't know. Maybe when it ricochets, it gets... The projectile should get bigger or something. I think that'd be really cool. Like, it encouraged you to shoot objects and things to bounce the shots. Maybe the projectiles should slow down. They should slow down, but start to track a little bit. Ooh, how cool would that be? A little bit of tracking. They slow down, and at some point they stop moving. I don't know. I feel like this is going to be a gun that definitely gets left behind in Destiny 2. It just, after Destiny 1, it's just gone. It's a very cool looking gun. I do enjoy the aesthetics. Aesthetics of it. It's a very nice looking gun. I like the bullpup design. I like that it's an auto rifle with that design, because that's the pulse rifle design. That's good. Alright, glass half full. I really didn't feel the need for spray and play. I mean, it's got good enough reload, especially with my gloves that reload auto rifle quicker. We're gonna go Accurize just to see what that does for us. Maybe it'll be the sweet spot. The sweet spot for impact instability. Not likely though. Not likely. If you could pick one gun in Destiny to carry into Destiny 2, what would it be? Let's say one exotic and one legendary. What would it be? My exotic would be the Mighty Multitool. My legendary... it'd either be between the 2NL SR4 with this one with this talent setup, or this Arminius D. And I know this is a very off-meta Arminius D, but it's amazing. Focus fire, crowd control. I think it has hand leads. Well, it has a rifled barrel, actually. It has high caliber rounds, fitted stock, and rifled barrel. It's an extremely good version of that. And you wouldn't expect it. You wouldn't look at it and go, oh, that's amazing. You would look at it and go, that's weird. But once you play with it, you're like, oh, yes. I understand now. Okay, so Twilight Gap. For the hard light, it should be good. It should do all right. We're gonna do some clash, so there will be no objectives. Flash. The only objective is murder dare. Murder dare is the objective. I like to do my murdering before breakfast. All right. That's not the way to start. Not with the Matator. Oh, throw a grenade there. Did he really headshot me while I was falling with the Queen Breaker's bow? Like, that would be impressive with a sniper rifle, but with a Queen Breaker's bow where you have to charge it? It's amazing. Oh, you're mine. I do want to kill some people with ricochet rounds. Like, it just doesn't feel like it hits them enough. Maybe that one did. Alright, Len, what's up? Are you a vampire? What are you doing? Is that half of a smiling, or is that a cry face? I don't understand emotes. I don't register them. My brain... Ouch. What? Where was that grenade? I just walked into it twice. Like a dumb. Straight up dumb right there, fellas. Straight up dumb. Straight up now, Tim. Do you really want to walk into my grenade? Oh, oh, oh. Just hip fire it from now on. Hip fire seems to be effective. Palindrome. Sometimes I play these matches and it's like, we're just doing Clash. There's no point to it. You don't have to win it. And I'm like, guys, get some more fun in your games. Like, why are you using these guns? Like the Clever Dragon palindrome type situation. Use something else. Use something fun. I think hip firing the hard light actually is pretty effective. You don't really have to aim. Just kind of shoot. Aim and shoot. Go for the assist, though. You're going to want to follow a team, bro. What? Again? How is he doing this? I really don't know how he's doing this. It's kind of messing with me. But yeah, hip fire's pretty fun with this gun. He's a dragon man. The dragon. Oh, why do you have a grenade already on me? You're a liar. Well, 1-on-1 engagements, you're a little at a disadvantage with the top tier meta weapons. Group engagements, you're in a bad situation. Did he universal remote me twice? And that killed me? I feel like the range was too far away for that. Gunplay analysis from death from above. Every gunplay analysis, or every gun battle gets analyzed. Alright, that was effective. The stability feels good right now. Like, I feel like I've hit the sweet spot with the stability. You freaking queen breaker. Please clean that up. Thank you. Oh, yay, look at that. The stream's having hiccups again. My internet's been a little goofy lately, so if you can hear the video but you can't see any gameplay, like, it freezes, it'll be back, don't worry. Not gonna get him. I'm sorry about this, guys. It's my internet. I don't know what's going on. It's pissing me off. My wife, I said that last night, and my wife was like, maybe it's the weather. I'm like, I surely hope not. That would be the stupidest thing ever. Ooh, you died. Get out of here. Ha! Get out of here. Oh, with the Queen Breakers. Oh no, that Luna Chiral? And the blue. Might even be a green. I'll give him that. I'll give him that. Oh, you just got vacancied. I know what happened to you. I should have another grenade. No, I don't. No. Can I please with my shoulder charge? Oh yes! Timed it perfectly. That's what you do with a Titan when you don't have a shotgun available. Where is he? At least I wasn't killed by the guy I was trying to go. Alright. I always say alright when I'm ready to do something. I feel like I've been doing bad. Alright. Oh, you just got team shot. I really want to get this heavy. Of all the places, of all the people, and all the things, I had to run into a blade dance right there. I'll just take my special ammo and be gone. So sad. It's so sad. Oh, did you say you wanted to get shoulder slidey shoulder charged? Oh, dang it. Missed him. Oh, I got him, though, still. Thank you. Yeah, the stability feels alright right now. I don't know what... what the deal is with max stability, like the max available stability, it didn't feel so good. With this, it feels good. Feels like the range is just right. Feels like the stability is just right. He's gonna get me. Yep. Headshots are difficult though. Headshots with an auto rifle are difficult to get consistently. Just because if it's bouncing left or right, you're gonna have trouble. Ooh. It didn't look like he was in super. Be right back. Babysitter situation.
Please enjoy my dancing.
Ooh, a Titan mark. Alright, so, babysitter issues. We got it sorted, but I'm going to have to go ahead and go, guys. So, let's do some final analysis on the hard light, then I'm going to head out. So, the hard light, mid-impact, mid-ready-fire, auto-rifle. Dry Bones, what's up? I'm feeling like it's a good gun. It could be better. I don't... You know, maybe a little bit of stability changes, something like that. But the way I have it set up right now is pretty decent. I felt like this was the best for me setup. Like, you, max stability doesn't give you any huge advantage because the inherent stability is not too good. So go for max range, mid impact, because you can get a little bit more impact out of aggressive, but you're going to lose a lot of stability and range. I go for that. I don't think you need to use spray and play. It's got quick enough reload and quick enough handling where that's not necessary. And glass half full is kind of useful. You do notice that. I wish that was something, but we've already got the exotic, so this just has to be a normal talent. So glass half full is fine. Volatile light, pretty cool. Definitely enjoy. So anyway, guys, that's it on the hard light. Is it worthy of an exotic? I think so, but I do believe it needs a little bit of tweak. So that's my final verdict on the hard light. But what do you guys think? Let me know in the comments if you're watching the video. Let me know. That's pretty terrible. It's a pretty terrible mark. I don't like the way it looks. It's kind of ugly. But anyway, let me know in the comments what you think about the Hard Light. What other guns do you want me to take a look at? Always feel free to suggest guns. Be like, hey, you should like this gun. It's really cool. Or compare these. Ooh, exotic. Compare these two. So that's kind of what I like doing. It's enjoyable for me, even if I'm just playing the same thing in the game with the same guns. I like when you have like a different angle at something, it makes it interesting in a different way. I kind of like to bring that to the table. So, but I am going to get out of here. You guys have an awesome day. Thanks so much for being here. You did miss the stream. I am ending a little bit early. Dad responsibilities and life and work and stuff. So it happens. I like to go to about 7. It's about 6:50. But I'm going to run out and go do the dad thing. So you guys have an awesome day. Thanks for hanging out. I'll be back tomorrow. I am here every day now, though. Point at you, camera. Anyway, thanks, guys. I'll see you tomorrow. See you, bye. I might try to get on tonight. Keep one eye on the sky. See you, bye. Taken out. How interesting.